First one up, Mississippi State heads to Texas A&M, 7 p.m. Eastern time kick. A&M, a 7-point favorite, total of 46. And, brother, the biggest mismatch in this game is the A&M passing defense. They are number two in EPA per pass defense, and, of course, that's all State does. State was actually able to run the ball against LSU and then went away from it for whatever reason. They were having success, and they went away from that side of the ball. But that's what Mike Leach does. They do not run the ball. Like they throw it at like a 75% clip. It's just insane. If you're going to do that against A&M, against this secondary, against this defensive line, best of luck, man. Like I understand Zach Calzada didn't look great last week, but this Mississippi State defense is not the Arkansas defense. This is a whole different
beast. Not even close. Yeah, Calzada's going to look that. Now, hang on. The State defense is good. They're not Arkansas.
Exactly.
That Arkansas defense is right, baby.
Yes, it's absolutely. You're 100% right about that. So I'm rolling A&M minus 7. I don't see Jimbo going to 3-2 the week before the Alabama game because that fan base will turn on him very, very quickly. So I'll take A&M minus the 7 here.
Man, we're agreeing way too much. It scares the shit out of me. But I'm with you. I'm with you. I think this A&M team is much better than they've played. I think they know they need to win, and they need to win in the most desperate kind of way. Here's the biggest problem with Rodgers and Mississippi State and then throwing the football is his accuracy is just so inconsistent right now. So he just, you know, I don't know what to do with that. Like the 3.5 quarters, he looked like crap. Well, maybe 3 quarters. He looked like crap against LSU. In the fourth quarter, he's just dropping dimes right and left. I'm thinking if you could play 3 quarters that way and only be 1 quarter shitty, like, you'd win the majority of your games. But I don't know if he's capable of doing that.
I don't know that he is either. So I'm going to choose to believe that on the road, he is not going to be nearly as successful. And we'll both roll with A&M. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures. Or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.